Well, Kevin, a great weekend for the Dundee Stars, 3 points.
Yeah, actually, I think it should have been four. We battled hard in Edinburgh, and I think we didn't get the reward we actually should have gotten. And we showed today that that's the way we should be playing, and we got the 2 points, and too bad we didn't get a four-point weekend, but at least three is better than nothing.
Yeah, for you personally as well, a great night, 5 goals, I think, and an assist.
I got 4. Morsi tipped that one in front. Yeah, but that doesn't matter. Like, we're playing good as a full team right now, and our line is really going well with Vinny and Swiss picking up where Joey Seitz actually is out right now. So I think it's a team effort. It doesn't matter if one guy scores 4 goals or 3 goals or 1 goal. It's what we do at the end, and the 2 points matter.
And as a team, as you say, a team unit, there must be a good lot of confidence in there going into the Cardiff game on a Wednesday night now, especially after such a successful weekend.
Yeah, it's always nice because I think we were like battling a bit, and we needed this because we miss a lot of bodies. So it's not an excuse, definitely not an excuse for me, but I think it's good. Like, you can see in the room right now, everyone's happy, everyone's good, and especially good going into such a nice trip all the way to Cardiff.
Yeah, a long trip, as you say, but especially with the injuries, as you say, little moments like this weekend, and especially the team's league standings at the moment, because they're right in the mix of everything, despite the injuries and the last few weeks. So it's all positive, really.
It actually is, yeah. Maybe if we didn't have those injuries, it wouldn't be higher. But right now, I think we're doing a really good job with the guys we have. I said it before, I think we should just not think about the guys we don't have, but think about the guys we do have. And a lot of guys stepping up, you know, like Benny and Ledge, they're doing a really good job filling in. And I really appreciate young guys stepping up and in bigger games in the last couple of weeks when guys are injured.
Yeah, as you say, that the two guys tonight getting the rewards as well, Ben Edmonds and Cameron McGiffin as well, stepping up. The young guys who have to be called upon and relied upon in times like at the moment.
Yeah, exactly. I think Givka's his first goal, that's almost like karma, you know, like something he worked his bag off, and then he gets his first goal. I think that's perfect, and that's big congratulations for him, obviously.
And finally, the fans could see your Christmas jumper. What was the inspiration behind choosing that one?
Well, I like to watch movies a lot, actually, and I like Marvel movies too. So this is Deadpool. I went with that one. Didn't really. It was either this one or Star Wars, but.
Well, you'll need to wear it again on the way down to Cardiff. Clearly, good luck for you, and best of luck for the game.
Might be a little hot in the bus, but.
Yeah, 10 hours or whatever. But yeah, best of luck in a way, Kevin. Thanks very much, and congratulations on your weekend.
Thank you.
Well, Mark, a great weekend for the Stars, 3 points.
Well, it's a big 3 points, and, you know, we got to keep in this playoff race with other teams. And obviously, we want to get off the mat here a little bit. We've had a tough couple of weeks with some injuries and guys out. But the guys have been battling, and they found a way to get it done tonight.
Yeah, last night, an overtime loss to the Caps. Were you disappointed last night in the end after taking the lead like you did?
Well, we got to take the positives. Going into last night, we were 4 points out of fourth place. Going into today, we're 3 points out of fourth place. So you got to take the positives. You know, we did have a 3-1 lead. But, you know, they're a hell of a hockey team, Edinburgh. They keep coming back on a lot of teams. And, you know, we found a way to get it done tonight. And, you know what, 3-point weekend, I'm happy with that.
Yeah, back to tonight. A great first period from the Stars. You would have been delighted with that. But probably what impresses you more is maybe the third period where they showed the character to continue on and get the 2 points.
Well, I think with a young team, when you get up a bunch of goals in a game like that, I think it's just human nature. You take your foot off the gas. You start making plays you don't normally make. You start cheating on the wrong side of the puck. And, you know, we corrected a few things in the second intermission, and we came out flying in the third period. Obviously, Hammer's goal on the power play at the start of the third was a big goal for us to get us back going.
Yeah, he had a great night. Of course, a lot of assists as well. Kevin Bruijsten, another guy that's put a lot of points on the board tonight.
Well, he has as hard a shot as anybody in the league, and I told him to use it more. And obviously, tonight he took full advantage of that. You know, we want to keep that going. We need that consistency from him. He's one of our top-line guys. We brought him in to score some goals for us, and hope he continues that.
And you've praised the Brits over the last few weeks, but Ben Edmonds and McGiffin producing the goods as well tonight.
Well, it was nice to see them score some goals and chip in offensively. Obviously, I gave Giff and obviously Josh some more ice time tonight. Obviously, Chris more than he did last night. And, you know, it's good for those guys, you know, to get some ice time in a game like that. And hopefully they carry on for the future.
And, of course, a lot of people will say that the 10 goals may be a result of a missing goalie for Edinburgh tonight. But I suppose you can only play what you've got in front of you.
Well, exactly. And I said that to the guys. You can only play what's in front of you. And, you know, we got to take advantage of that sometimes. And you know, sometimes with the backup goalie going in there, they get hot. You see, O'Brien, they had some great results with Gary Russell in there. So I told the guys, shoot the puck. Don't turn down shooting opportunities and drive the net. And, you know, we got some great bounces as well. And, you know, we took advantage of it.
And talking to goalie, Sheepdog getting some ice time tonight as well.
Well, exactly. When we got the 5-1, I thought it, so that's when I started thinking about it. Then we made 5-3. Obviously, you know, that changed pretty quickly. But, you know, I asked him on the third period if he was ready to go in, and he said, yeah. And, you know, Sheep works so hard for us every day. He's got a great partnership there with Joe, and, you know, he deserves some ice time.
And, of course, with the Stars' injury crisis at the moment, to be in the mix of everything still at this point and looking pretty decent, that'll be a real positive for you.
Oh, it is a positive. You know, we just got to find points every weekend, any way we can. And, you know, hopefully we have some good news this week with getting some bodies back. Probably not for the game on Wednesday against Cardiff in the Cup, but hopefully by Friday against Nottingham. If not, hopefully by Boxing Day. But it's a day-to-day thing. I trust my medical staff to get these guys ready, and we want to make sure they're fully fit.
Well, the Cardiff game next on Wednesday night, of course. 10 goals tonight will be a real morale boost on that journey down there.
Well, it's good for the guys. It's not just the 10 goals. I think just the winning. And we got a winning atmosphere back in that dressing room. Obviously, the morale is pretty high after this weekend. You know, Carson, they're in first place for a reason. And we have to go down there, you know, winner take all. We're down by 3 goals, same position we were last year. But we're going down there a day early. We're going to do it right. And hopefully come up with the result.
And 10 goals tonight with your Christmas jumper on show. You're going to be wearing that for the rest of the festive period?
No, the guys are ribbing me about it. They told me I should better wear that on Wednesday. But we'll see. I mean, it's obviously, you know, this time of year we'll have a bit of fun. Obviously, the couple of weeks that we've had, we want the guys to put a smile on their face a little bit. So hopefully that helped, and we carry on to Wednesday.
Well, congratulations, and best of luck on Wednesday. Thanks, Mark.
Perfect. Thank you.